I'm going to remind the people about Martin, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King's views on nonviolence, but using nonviolence to address oppression. Oppression can last a long time and have many consequences, but resistance has the power to overcome oppression and shorten its length. The great Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King spoke of oppression and explained three ways on how people could deal with that oppression. The first way is through acquiescence, which means to reluctantly accept something without protest. He described it as a type of negative freedom and resignation that engulfs the life of the oppressed. To accept passively an unjust system is to cooperate with that system. The second is resorting to physical violence. He believed that we should never use violence. We can never bring peace that way. And it seems to be the last resort. The old eye for an eye only leaves everyone blind, and this system promotes more violence. The third is nonviolent resistance that strives to reconcile between two opposite sides. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. believed in this method. He believed that no individual or group need to submit to any wrong, nor need anyone resorts to violence in order to right a wrong. Nonviolent resistance is not aimed against oppressors, but against oppression. Under its banner, consciences, not racial groups, are enlisted. Right now in Trinidad and Tobago, for many citizens, life is a struggle. I want to tell you that the struggles you are facing offer you much more value than any other time in your life. It is forcing you to become better citizens, to work on yourselves, to ensure that your futures are brighter because the establishment has failed you. You have two primary choices in life: to accept conditions as they exist, or accept the responsibility for changing those conditions. If you don't like the conditions, change them. You can let things define you, destroy you, or oppress you. It is your choice. Every morning you have two choices. Continue to sleep with the SOE, that suppression of expression, or wake up and chase your dream of becoming free from oppression. Get up, stand up, stand up for your rights. This is Diana Benskin, aka The Storm, bidding you auf Wiedersehen until we meet again on Saturday. Thank you, Mr. Nero, for joining us tonight. Auf Wiedersehen.